Our today's topic is Bluetooth technology. So in two parts we will discuss this one. In the first part we will have basics. So Bluetooth is wireless technology, and as we know it is a short range radio technology developed for PAN, that is personal area network. This is a standard, Bluetooth is a standard developed by group of electronic manufacturers that allows any sort of electronic equipment from computers and cell phones to keyboards, headphones to get connected and to make its own connections without wires, cables or any direct action from user. It is an ad hoc type network operable over a small area such as within one room without any obstacle. Bluetooth wireless technology makes it possible to transmit signals over short distances between telephones, computers, other devices, and therefore it is a simple communication and synchronization between devices. It is a global standard. N number of applications are there as far as Bluetooth is considered. In the case of general wired applications, the way we are implementing on the same line, there are n number of applications based on such connectivity. It is going to eliminate the wires and cables between small stationary as well as mobile devices within limited area. It is going to facilitate both data and voice communication, and it offers possibility of ad hoc network and delivers ultimate say synchronous type of connection between and among. It is a dynamic standard, whereas devices can automatically find each other and they are going to establish their connections when they discover. So it is a wireless LAN technology designed to connect devices of different functions such as telephones, notebooks, computers, cameras, printers, maybe coffee maker and so on. Bluetooth LAN is an ad hoc network, which means that network is formed spontaneously. Here ad hoc itself means it is the most dynamic connectivity. In the coming part of this session, we will discuss about architecture and Bluetooth layers. So here you can see Bluetooth is basically a protocol stack. So it is divided in three parts. One is application group, second one is middleware group, and third one is transport group. So core protocols are coming under this middleware protocol group and transport protocol group. It is flexible as possible, compatible with legacy protocols and applications. So you can reuse it. Most profiles spring from usage models, however some profiles are general. Profile can be considered transport profile, upon which application profile, like that. So the specific which protocol elements are mandatory in certain applications, this is going to get specified, and as per that the particular protocol is inserted. Profiles concept prevents devices with limited memory and processing power from implementing the entire Bluetooth. So transport protocol, you can see the general structure, and from that you can have like from audio application, then there may be a sort of control, then there is a data. So layer wise, like you can see in the diagram, that is radio layer, baseband layer, and in between there is HCI, audio, L2CAP control and link management. So all these are present, and audio application and middleware data applications, they are going to get say processed via the particular protocol. So these protocols fit best within the data link layer and physical layer of OSI model, that is transport layer protocols, and they are going to establish raw bit pipes between devices as if. So transport protocol group is shown here, you can see. Then middleware protocol group, so here this is the general structure. Like you can have this audio control, SDP, TCP, UDP, IRMC, OBX, IP, PPP, telephony control, then RFCOM, TCS bin, networking application, then n number of like all these audio applications and so on. So all that that is present to application layers standard interfaces that allow applications to use a higher level of abstraction than would direct communications with the lower layer transport protocols. So RFCOM and SDP, these are main two. They are helping to middleware protocol group. Then there comes application level protocol group. So there is profile applications, new future applications, platform applications, common devices are to be connected, Bluetooth applications, in number of. So here legacy applications and Bluetooth specific applications. So those protocols that reside above protocol stack as defined by SIG. So some of the protocols like middleware group could be considered as application layer protocols also. So they are helping. Now this is basically the structure, or which we call as an architecture of Bluetooth. So it is made up of, you can see here, radio baseband, link manager and L2C AP, that is a, then host controller interface, that is HCI, then application framework and support. So RF layer is there, baseband layer is there, link manager, L2 cap, then data, and at the application side there may be a helping hand. So protocols are there for control mechanism, and SDP, RFCOM, TCS and all these others are also there based on version. They are helping altogether. So as you can see, this is a general structure where you can observe the architectural view. As far as Bluetooth is considered, there are two types of networks conventionally used. First one is called PicoNet. So the primary is connected with secondary as shown in figure. So this is a comparatively small ad hoc network, normally 8 stations maximum. So like out of them, one is called master, or you can call it as primary, and rest of others are secondary or slaves. All slave stations synchronizes their clock with the master. Then possible communication one to one or one to many is carried out. Then there may be one station in park state. Each PicoNet has unique hopping pattern, that is ID, or it is called ID. And each master can connect to 7 simultaneous or 200 plus inactive, that is park slaves per PicoNet. So this is a feature. Though maximum 7 are possible, but secondary in a park state is synchronized with primary and cannot take part in communication until it is moved from the park state. So since only 8 are there, so after each particular application or the particular work, assigned work over, immediately it is released. So this is the main mechanism taken care under PicoNet type of a connectivity. Then the second category is called ScatterNet. So you can see in the figure, so there is a primary, secondary, and again primary, secondary is shown, that is one PicoNet is there, it is a part, and again there are a number of secondary stations. So this is as if by making one slave, one of the slave, as a master of another PicoNet. So ScatterNet is formed by combining several such PicoNets, you can see. So ScatterNet is the linking of multiple co-located PicoNets, you can see in the figure, through sharing of common master or slave device. Device can be both master as well as slave, and radios are symmetric, right? That can be master or slave, whatever. Then high capacity system, so maximum capacity of 720 kbps per PicoNet as far as considered. So this is called ScatterNet connectivity. In general, Bluetooth devices are like short range radio transmitter. The current data rate is 1 Mbps with 2.4 GHz bandwidth. So there is a possibility of interference between the IEEE 802.11 wireless LAN and Bluetooth LAN. So one has to be very careful in that case. as far as range and power classes are considered in case of Bluetooth. So you can see here as in the table. So these are transmitter characteristics in general. So range is mentioned 100 meter, 10 meter and 1 meter. In case of power class 1, it is designed for long range, that is 100 meters range, with maximum output power of we used to get it 20 dB. These are some old specifications, but no doubt this is standard one. So 20 dB and nominal output power not applicable. Minimum output power is 1 milliwatt and P minimum is 4 dB to P max maximum. So in that range power control is possible. Then second class is, that is the ordinary range devices. So it is up to 10 meter devices with maximum output power of 4 dB. Here you can see the maximum output power 4 dB, and that is in milliwatts it is 2.5 milliwatt. In case of 100 meters, you can see in the table it is 100 milliwatt. And nominal output power in case of 10 meter radio Bluetooth 1 milliwatt, and minimum output power is 0.25 milliwatt minus 6 dB, and optional is P minimum square to P max. So that is in general. And the third category, that is class 3, this is for short range devices, and here it is up to 1 meter. Maximum output power is 1 milliwatt, that is 0 dB, and rest of is not applicable. So this is range and power classes associated. So here the baseband layer is roughly equivalent to max sublayer in LANs. The access method is TDMA. The primary and secondary communicate with each other using time slots. The length of time slot is exactly same as dwell time, 625 microseconds. And during time that one frequency is used, a sender sends a frame to secondary, or secondary sends a frame to primary. The communication is only between primary and secondary, and secondaries cannot communicate directly with each other. As far as TDMA is considered, it is time division duplex TDMA. So it is TDD TDMA used by Bluetooth. It's a kind of half duplex communication in which secondary and receiver send and receive data, but not at the same time. So the communication for each direction uses different hops, and this is kind of something which is very similar to older walkie-talkie type of communication. In single secondary communication, the Piconet has only one secondary, primary and secondary. You can see in the figure, 625 milliseconds is a duration, and hop by hop, F0, F1, F2, F3 and so on. So divided into 625 microseconds, the time the primary uses even number slot and secondary is using say odd number slot. So 1, 2, 1, 3 like that. You can see in the figure, colors in primary, 0th slot, 2nd slot like that, and in secondary 1, 3, 5 and so on in the half duplex mode. And in slot 0, primary sends and secondary receives. In slot 1, secondary sends and primary receives. So you can see. Then this is a single secondary communication. In case of multiple secondary, there is small mistake in the figure. It is 25 microseconds. The other figure is also 366 microseconds. Now multiple secondary communication. So here it is. If there is more than one secondary, then this is used. So you can see the hopping. Primary uses even number slot. Secondary sends next odd number slot. If the packet in the previous slot was addressed to it, all secondaries going to listen and on even number slot, but only one secondary sends in any odd number slot. So you can see here, in the first slot, first secondary has sent, and in the third slot, second secondary has sent. So at a time, only one secondary can communicate. So this is basically the feature. As far as this baseband communication is considered, we have this BB standard, like Bluetooth device address, then AM address, that is active member address, parked member address, and access request address. So all these addresses are also taken care. Then there is a frame format. general Bluetooth frame format. So it is access code, then 54 bits header, then 0 to n bits data, and below that from header there is a, you can see here address type FAS and HEC. So n equal to 240 for one slot frame, n equal to 1490 for third slot frame, and n equal to 2740 for fifth slot frame. So this 18 bit part is repeated three times. So one by one we will comment on each one of it. Header is 54 bit field, you can see, and repeated 18 bit pattern. Each pattern has the subfields as shown. First one is address, so 3 bit address subfield, define up to 7 secondaries, 1 to 7. If the address is 0, it is used for broadcast communication from primary to all secondaries. Then second subfield is type, the 4 bit type subfield defines type of data coming from upper layers. So next is F, this is 1 bit is for flow control. So when it is set to 1, it indicates that device is unable to receive more frames, buffer is full. Then A, this is 1 bit subfield, it is acknowledgement. So this is Bluetooth is going to use a stop and wait ARQ type of automatic request type of protocol. So 1 bit is sufficient for acknowledgement. Then there is bit S. So S is subfield hold sequence number, so it uses stop and wait, so therefore 1 bit is sufficient again for sequence numbering 0 or 1. Then HES, the 8 bit header error correction subfield, so it is a checksum to detect errors in each 18 bit header section. The header has 3 identical 18 bit sections. The receiver compares these 3 sections bit by bit. If each one of the corresponding bit is same, the bit is accepted, and if not, the majority options are given up. This is form of forward error correction. The double error correction is needed because the nature of communication is very noisy. There is no retransmission in this sublayer. And then there is a field payload. So this is from 0 to 2740 bits long. It contains data or control information coming from upper layers. So this is about the frame format and the respective say details. Now as far as various protocols are considered, then the spectrum is total 79 megahertz with out of band regulations in each country. Guard bands are used. The Bluetooth transceiver is frequency hopping spread spectrum radio system. So geography regulated range gigahertz, you can see here 2.4 to 2.4835, and RF channels 2.402 plus n is equal to, or k is equal to, here you can just name it as k, 0, 1, 2 up to 78, total 79 channels. Lower guard band is 2 megahertz and upper guard band is 3.5 megahertz. So operational parameters as far as considered for Bluetooth, then there is a modulation, symbol rate, FH rate, transmit power and receiver sensitivity. So modulation is GFSK and VT equal to 0.5, modulation index is 0.28 to 0.35. Symbol rate is 1 Mbps, so using binary GFSK 1 Mbps. Then FH rate is 1600 hops, typically that is 625 microseconds per hop, and 3200 hops inquiries and pages, so it is of 312.5 microseconds per hop. Then class 1 20 dB 100 milliwatt, required power control is to at least 4 dB, optional PC to below minus 30 dB, transmit power feature. Then our parameter, class 2 is 4 dB 2.5 milliwatt and optional PC as above, and class 3 is 0 dB 1 milliwatt, optional PC is as above, that is as we can see minus 30 dB, below minus 30 dB. And receiver sensitivity must attain a raw BER of 0.1% with minus 70 dB meter or lower, and the minus 70 dB sensitivity is for any signal by any complaint Bluetooth transmitter. In the next part, we will discuss about service delivery service discovery protocol, and that is BB, all details, and some part of telephone control protocol, and API, that is application program interface, and radio frequency communication, logical link control and adaption, that is and host control interface. So all these things in the second part of Bluetooth discussion we will proceed. Thank you.